This summer, you could often find Ben Hewson sharing his notes with Professor Charley Liberko in the chemistry lab during the Cornell Summer Research Institute. They're hoping that something that started out as a simple idea could turn into something much more.
There's this idea that wood is composed of these two polymers, cellulose and lignin. And most of the time, what we're doing is we're taking the wood and we're getting rid of the lignin and throwing that part away to keep the cellulose. And the cellulose is what we use for the paper. And so many times, this huge amount of lignin, which is the second most abundant polymer on Earth, just goes to waste. And so I had it in my mind, what can we do with lignin? And then as I thought about water and I thought about getting rid of metal ions in water that might be contaminating things, I thought, well, lignin should be a perfect thing for that.
That idea fell in line with Hewson's plans for the future. He wants to be a doctor to help people. So now he's exploring one aspect of that through the test tubes of this chemistry lab.
I'm really excited about it, especially since it's a new project and I kind of get to pioneer it my own way. I really do feel pretty good about it, knowing that this could potentially be something that's really big and great.
Here's how it works. They heat up ordinary sawdust in an oven at 190 degrees to remove the cellulose. Then the remaining lignin and the metal solution get mixed together.
I'm working with iron, copper, nickel, and lead so far.
The lignin acts as a sponge with the metal, so Ben pours the solution into a filter, which leaves behind water with a reduced amount of metal.
And then in order to be able to test whether or not we're removing the metal ions, we have the instrumentation that will do that for us. But most people don't have the instrumentation that we have here. And so we're developing tests for concentrations of different metal ions that rely on color.
All it takes is one drop of this potassium ferrous cyanide, and so that creates a color reaction.
We are able to remove sometimes up to 90% of the metal ions in the water, and of course we're just getting started.
It's an idea that could make a big difference for people across the world, and a big difference for one aspiring doctor.
I get to work in a lab on a campus that I'm comfortable with a professor that I know, and so I feel comfortable asking questions and learning and even making mistakes and learning from those and getting better.
This is just one example of the many research projects going on for CSRI. For others, visit our website at cornellcollege.edu/research.